and staff, thank you for joining us today. We are excited to bring you this year's music performance titled Mastering Math. The kids have spent months learning dance routines, scripts, and songs.
All Danbrook students have buckled down this year and put extra effort toward reading and math. We are all motivated to raise the test scores and are anxiously awaiting to hear the results. I know we have made some great progress.
Problem solving in math is one area Danbrook teachers have spent extra time and energy. Our musical performance, Mastering Math, is a Sherlock Holmes problem solving mystery that takes us through the important steps to solving most math problems.
Let's watch and see how the famous detective Sherlock Holmes overcame his fears of problem solving.
Stop it. repossess my hat. In that case, he is.
We need your help, Mr. Holmes.
You do? Are you sure?
That's gonna bring all the horror.
Why don't you just go to the box and open it?
There's not an unwritten key and there are thousands of boxes.
Oh, the horror!
The thief also has the number of the box.
Holmes?
Yes, sir. No, sir. I mean, work through the problem in reverse.
Can someone from the audience help us with that one? Everybody?
Work backwards!
Work backwards. Yes, that's correct.
It looks like Sherlock Holmes needs more strategies to help him feel more comfortable with problem solving. Let's see if he has any luck at the bicycle shop.
Have you seen a thief? We're in search of one.
A thief? No, but 2 hours ago we rented a bicycle shop in a big hurry.
2 hours ago?
Yes, right at noon. I said that a man named Holmes would be asking after him, and we were to inform him that he was running to Sheffield.
Trent, we'll never catch him.
If I may, Sheffield is 50 miles away. The man was going to make about 10 miles an hour. Left 2 hours ago. If you and your friend here were to break...
Easy, Holmes.
How can we figure out if we'll ever catch up to him? It's hopeless.
When I get stuck in these kind of problems, I just make a table.
That sounds easy enough. I once made an entire dinette set.
No, but
the
table, I'm in a chart to draw a chart.
Thank you.
the islands of Sheffield.
Tables and charts are great. They can really help you see the problem.
Remember, you don't have to be rampant. You don't have to master art.
You don't need a brush or an easel to draw a table or a chart.
Looks like now we're off to Sheffield.
Thank you. You won't drown, Holden. That was one. Then the second one. And finally the third one. She's more aggressive than the others. That each of you blows come with me on the portrait.
We come with look.
You.
Hey, wait! That would mean you have to row across the river 7 times. Isn't there something faster?
I've got an idea. What if my brother and doctor want to could start by taking one of my sisters?
Wait, that leaves me here with 2 sisters.
I know.
Watson!
It's okay, I've got a plan. What if we first send all 3 sisters across?
Yes, yes, by all means, let them go first.
Aren't you sweet?
Sweet? Me? No, I'm rather tart, I think. Yes, absolutely sour. Terrible tasting, really. Nothing sweet at all.
I think Dr. Watson is onto something. Listen, the 3 of us sisters row across like this. And I row back and pick up the stuff from Dr. Watson. That keeps 2 of you in just one boat. I drop you off on the other side, so then there are 2 of us sisters and 2 of you men.
Thank you.
then it must be 5 steps from the middle to the bottom. Then there must be a total of
11 steps. Excellent, Mom. The only building with 11 steps is the middle one. It seems to be some sort of school. Let's go.
We just played two more strategies. Does anyone remember? Again, act it out and draw a picture.
I don't know about Sherlock, but I'm sure I am feeling confident about problem solving. We have one more strategy to go.
And begin to see a pattern forming.
This place looks very familiar, Watson, but I just can't put my finger on it.
What kind of school is this? Middle school? High school?
Elementary, my dear Watson.
It seems like we've run into another obstacle. This is a four-story building, and there are dozens of rooms. The thief could be anywhere.
Hey, look, some of the students. Stay there. Did you see a man come in here a few minutes ago?
No.
Uh-oh.
Fine. Right.
But some lady did hand us enough to give it to a man in houses.
Houses? Oh, you mean homes!
Whatever.
Here's what it says. If you want to find the crook, here's the room where you should look. Here's some numbers in a series. What comes next to the luck rankings? 1, 4, 13, 40, and 21.
Oh, that's a stumper, all right.
Very odd. Who was it that used to call me dude? I know I've heard that before.
You should do what a teacher says.
Yeah, you just have to look for a pen.
Find a pattern. I think I see it now, do you?
No.
You find a pattern, that's what matters. The answer's coming into view. Yeah, I can't see a find a pattern. Now can't you see the nice design?
No.
Find a pattern, that's what matters. The problem's working out just fine. Wait a minute. It may look random, but you'll see the numbers share some property. For the next step is some key. You've got to find the recipe.
I think I've got it.
Find a pattern. Find a pattern. I think I see it now, do you?
Really?
Find the pattern, that's what matters. The answer's coming into view. The answer's coming in into view.
Of course, a pattern. I see it all. What's it? What? Between each of these numbers?
3, 9, 27, and 1.
Do you see? Each difference is 3 times larger than the previous one.
So the answer to our problem is 3 times 81?
Yes, exactly. 3 times 81 is 243. Add that to 121, the last number in our sequence, and you get 364. Come on, Watson. We've got an appointment with the thief and we're 364.
Well, there you have it. 6 strategies to help you solve all kinds of math problems.
You just have to decide which one works best for the type of problem you're trying to solve.
Let's check back in with Sherlock and see if he has overcome his fears of problem solving.
I know I have. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank all the terrific teachers at Danbrook that have helped us all become better, more confident problem solvers.
I wonder if Sherlock Holmes appreciates his teachers like we do.
Well, let's see.
Here we are. And the thief is off my elementary school. All my math teachers in one room.
Hello, Sherlock. You've grown.
You are the thief of the royal document?
There never was a royal document.
Or anything. We cooked up this entire adventure.
But why?
You always wanted to be a great detective, Sherlock. But you just never focused on your problem-solving skills during math class. So we decided to cook up this entire adventure, and we cooked it all up, and we designed this crash course in math. And there was never any story. We just invented. There was never any well-documented at all. We invented the whole thing.
And it worked. You've learned so many skills today. Now you just need to keep in mind the four steps of problem-solving.
Divide the plan.
Step 3, solve. Step 4, check back.
Sherlock Holmes has got to be feeling good after that. I should hope so.
Yes, at last! I'm a wonderful detective. Dr. Deduction, Prince of Problem Solving.
Congratulations, Holmes.
Don't move, Dr. Watson. I noticed your shoes have a slight space to play on them.
Yes, I suppose they do.
This is a very rare red clay, found only in the front porch of a left-handed sausage seller in Bombay during the monsoon season.
Remarkable.
Which leads me to my conclusion, Dr. Watson.
Yes?
That you have a trout in your pants.
I was wondering what I had done with this. Holmes, you really are a genius.
Thank you.